We've come a long, long way together, through the hard times and the good. I have to celebrate you, baby. I have to praise you like I should.
University, and we won the game 11-10 on a dubious decision by a young lad by the name of Rob McDonald, who was linesman for the day, and the ball went over the post, which are only half the size they should have been, and Rob bent it in, and one flag went up and one stayed down, and the ref nodded and blew the whistle, and we won the game 11-10. Then we went down to the Brelbar pub, and under the great tutelage of David Goodman, who was the self-appointed mayor and fire chief of Brelbar.
Right, McDonald. Yeah, same question. What's the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear the drivers?
Gunthorpe. Simple as that, Gunthorpe.
Mick, what's the first thing that comes to your mind when you think of the drivers?
Good times, good blokes, good piss, and success.
We'll be right back.
big loss from the Dragons, and still does that today.
McDonald, who do you feel made a difference at the
Dragons? Yeah, I'd go along with Bob Brennan. I'd have to say my dearest wife.
Yeah.
And probably Jamie Blight from all the years he's been there, from day one till up till now. So he's the most influential left.
John, in your many games and many years at the Drivers.
Oh, well, let me see.
Who do you think made a difference?
It's all a bit hazy now, but probably Wally. He was probably the guts,
Yeah.
The optimism was always there.
Who do you think made a difference?
Well, I think that's hard to narrow down, but you'd have to go in no specific order. Brownie, Cactus, certainly. Wallace.
I guess not just because I made his daughter shift to Toowoomba, but Cactus.
Hey, cats on the horse!
Thank you. riders would say, first jersey, first hat, go the drovers.
Yeah. Matt Terry, hung upside down.
Matt Terry, though.
Anything to do with Matt Terry?
Matt Terry.
Matt Terry.
Driving down to the sidewalk fair. Finger on the trigger, let me tell you, gave us quite a scare. Goddamn right, it's a beautiful day. Goddamn right, it's a beautiful day. We'll be right back.
jumbo jet. It wasn't easy. You please, having so much fun, gone and lost your reason after all is said and done. Well, are you still having fun? Well, how is you to know when you've gone astray that happiness will go like a lost emotion? You've always gone your way.
When we got our new shorts and they got washed, and next week everyone's genitalia was substantially more exposed than the week before.
I went to pick Stephen Hill up for a game one day and found him and his girlfriend dancing the lounge room to sexual healing.
Last year, Ash Kirk pulled onto this scar when she was off. She was alright. I could tell something was a bit up. Yeah, Kirky, that luck, she was a boy.
I probably spotted Lighten coming home from a pub one night. He felt a bit crook. Went to the toilet and lifted up the lid of the washing machine. We had a full load of washing in it at the time. He was picking carrots out of his face for weeks.
I saw Kane Emerson put his penis in Sam's mouth.
It had to be on the way back from an early beach trip one day. We had a new player on tour, Chris Stevenson, when Grant Austin donned the rubber glove and with a liberal amount of danker rub for lubrication, proceeded to give him a prostate check.
2 years ago was Hay Bale Day, the football box day. After the games, me, Kimbo Tyler, and the others had been playing and went to the football box, and we're putting the hay bales away, and Kim tried to throw two ladies up on the hay bales, but threw them inside the truck. It was pretty funny.
He'll get drunk.
Yeah! Seasons, the club has grown into a very spirited and financial model for true country rugby.
Never thought it'd go this far, but it's been unbelievable. And all three grades making grand final and not losing. Great feat, and congratulations to everyone involved.